Hello and welcome back to the Sharks World, ladies and gentlemen. Today we're going to cover a topic that has often been touched on, but I want to take it a step further. Everyone knows that sharks have survived the past 5 mass extinctions, but what I want to talk about is why sharks are able to survive such extreme events. How did nature mold these creatures to be so resilient? What adaptations did they develop because of it? Because let's be clear, extinction events are literal end-of-the-world scenarios. I don't think most people understand how catastrophic a mass extinction event is. Most of all life dies out. Habits drastically change. In fact, there are times when the ocean is worse off than the land. During the Permian-Triassic extinction, also known as the Great Dying, 90% of all life in the ocean died. 90. 10 less than 100. Think about that. And sharks are one of the few to survive this and following extinctions. So the obvious question is obvious. How did our higher order fish do it? Short answer, sharks as a whole are a stubborn species. Like, really stubborn. And me just saying that doesn't do it justice. So let's take a closer look, starting with food. One of the pillars of Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Food, in simple terms, is energy for an organism. Everything needs energy in some way, shape, or form. It's merely a question of how to get said energy. During extinction events, food is in very short supply, and being picky isn't an option. So how did sharks solve this problem? By being generalist hunters. While certain species can be picky eaters, most sharks are generalist predators. Or in other words, they have a lot of variety in their diets. It's also a big reason why sharks are often the only ones seen showing up at carcasses. They take what is available. Now, this may seem very simple at face value, but there are second and third order effects that stem from this. Let me paint a picture for you. Say an extinction event started happening, and we have two groups: dolphins, including orcas, and sharks. Both groups are successful and superb hunters, but with food being limited, the sharks would be far better off. Why? Because dolphins and orcas hunt what they are taught, at least from what I understand. This is the reason orcas in particular don't hunt humans. They simply haven't been taught to hunt us. Yet. But because of the extinction event and life dying off, food would be limited. The pods would have to learn to hunt new things, while sharks, being generalists, would have been taking what they could get. I'm sure the dolphins could figure something out, but that's time and energy spent learning and not eating. Now, to be clear, I'm not saying the way dolphins and orcas do things is bad. They're clearly successful in today's oceans. I'm just saying that it's different, and there are trade-offs because it's different. Another one being that the offspring of dolphins and orcas would struggle in an extinction event, as would any offspring. But because young dolphins and orcas rely on their parents, if something were to happen to said parents or other adults, say they die off because of limited food and/or other factors, that young dolphin now has to learn on its own. This, however, is just Tuesday for a young shark. Because shark pups get little to no investment from their parents, they're naturally used to figuring things out on their own. On top of having a generalist diet, which is another contributing factor to why sharks have survived mass extinctions. Young sharks are more independent than other young animals in terms of hunting. They naturally know to stay cautious, keep their heads down, and take whatever food they can get, even if it's a carcass. Another big reason why sharks survive mass extinctions is because they have access to something a lot of other animals don't. The deep. In the ocean, the surface area and the deep ocean are two very different worlds. Sharks, among other animals, always have the option to go deeper if things at the surface are in bad shape. Now, in fairness, not every shark species can thrive in the deep. Maybe survive, but not thrive. And going to the deep doesn't necessarily guarantee survival. There would clearly need to be some evolutionary adaptations over the years while the extinction event was going on. This is the biggest reason why Megalodon is dead. If some species decided to live in the deepest parts of the ocean during the extinction event, they would have to change and evolve into a completely different animal, to the point where it would no longer be Otis Megalodon. Being a giant has its trade-offs. That's what sharks do whenever things change. They adapt. In evolution, designed sharks to be the ultimate adapters. It did so by making sharks some of the most resilient creations in existence, which is another reason why they survive mass extinctions. They're the most efficient swimmers in the ocean because of their lightweight skeleton and dentical skin, while at the same time having more muscle than most, if not all other animals in the world, at 85% muscle in a typical shark's body. Strong muscles to move lighter weight with reduced drag helps sharks conserve energy. So much so that as sharks get bigger, it's actually easier for them to eat less and conserve energy. This adds to them having a generalist diet. And that's not all. While sharks aren't immune to cancer, they're very resistant to it and other diseases. Sharks are so adaptable that there are some that live in volcanoes and can even hold their breath to retain heat when going into deeper, colder waters. On top of all this, some females possess the ability to reproduce asexually when there is a lack of males around, in which they basically clone themselves from a genetic standpoint. I'm sure a lot of you have saw the story where a female shark in a zoo did exactly this. Of course, asexual reproduction has its own drawbacks, but during an extinction event, it helps a species survive for that much longer. But there's one factor, one crucial thing that truly takes sharks' ability to survive extinction-level events to the next level: their brain. Come on, you knew this was coming if you've been with my channel for a while. But I'm serious. The single greatest tool a shark has during an extinction event is their brain. For one, because sharks are some of the most intelligent animals on the planet, everyone underestimates just how smart sharks are. I've got plenty of videos on the topic. But it goes deeper than that. Shark brains possess better neuroplasticity than even human brains. For those who don't know, in simple terms, neuroplasticity is the brain's ability to change and adapt. Sure, we hairless murder apes can adapt to situations, but we always look for some sort of structure and try to set in patterns. Sharks adapt to situations quicker and much better than other creatures. And I would argue a big contributing factor to that is because sharks are left on their own as soon as they're born. Shark brains also possess something that humans don't: the ability to make new neurons. Let me put this into perspective. When a human child is born, they have all the neurons they will ever need, and they slowly die and decrease over time as the body ages. That's why you can't do the same things at 80 years old as you can do at 20 or 30 years old. Your brain and body deteriorate over time after they reach their peak. Sharks, however, do not have this limitation. Shark brains will continue to make new neurons as long as they're alive. And it makes perfect sense. The oldest vertebrate in the world is the Greenland shark, at over 400 years old. Even the spiny dogfish breaks the mold when it comes to smaller vertebrates. Smaller organisms in terms of lifespan generally burn bright, but burn fast, and don't live that long, at least compared to larger organisms. The spiny dogfish, however, can live up to 70 years old as a white shark. I would argue a big contributing factor to this is the shark brain's ability to make new neurons and keep going. This, alongside its neuroplasticity, perfectly positions sharks to ride out extinction-level events. Now, for proper context, all of this doesn't mean that sharks thrived during extinctions. It just means that sharks had and still have the tools to hold out until life begins to rebuild itself, surviving on what they could with a generalist diet, having the option to move to the deep ocean, conserving energy, and having the brain structure, abilities, and intelligence to adapt to whatever situations came about, makes sharks a very stubborn species to get taken out by an extinction. Because of these tools and these reasons, we still have the pleasure and honor of interacting with our higher order fish. If you ask me, sharks are the physical embodiment of perseverance and sheer grit. If there is one thing that can be certain, if the world ended tomorrow, somehow, some way, sharks would find a way and survive. This is going to be where we end today's video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you for once again giving me some of your time, and I'll see you in the next video. Until then.